Hi guys, how are you all? This is a very important video for our small and medium tour operators and tourism professionals. Either you are in B2B or B2C, either you are in domestic or outbound or both, either you are in conventional or unconventional or semi-unconventional tours. This is for all of those small and medium holiday owners and tourism professionals that I'm going to tell you about here. We all know post-pandemic, most of you are struggling either in your tourism business or profession. Most of the small and medium tourism owners are under the impression that still holiday business is at cessation. Am I right? Also, on the other hand, there are so many tourism professionals hunting for a job because most of them lost their job due to COVID's setback. Am I right? But what if I'll tell you that the established holiday business houses, those who are specialized in niche area, started doing well again? And getting inquiries as well as booking also. What if I'll tell you the big online companies have started doing well in selling hotel packages especially and quarantine packages? Have you, I mean the small and medium holiday owners, ever thought that why you are always behind and why you are dependent on others to pull up your business? So the question is, why there is no firmness in your business? Do you know why? Because of your mindset that has been injected by the market players. I'm only talking about the small and medium tour operators and travel and any level of travel professionals. And to the travel professionals, I would like to ask, why your job is always under threat that any time the employer will throw you out of the company? Tell me guys, how it feels that when the employer will be always under threat that his staff should not leave and go? And this can only happen when you will become an asset of the company and not a liability always. You're getting me? What I'm saying? My dear small and medium holiday owners, you are behind because you are scattered in bits and pieces. I'll tell you very simply. You people every month living with a hope that next month my business will be good. जैसे कि मोदी के दुकान में लिखा रहता है आज नगद कल उधार, that tomorrow never comes. So the next month hardly comes. Have you thought why? Do you know hope is a good breakfast but a bad supper? I don't mind giving this bold statement that you, the small and medium holiday owners, are making your partners dream true at your cost and effort, but you have no idea. You don't know your value even. And even I don't mind saying that many talented professionals are working all out to make others dream true. And in return, the most interesting part mostly is happening, and in return, they are shown rosy pictures at the beginning, and once the work is over, they are simply kicked out. So you need to learn how to get legitimate consideration from your business partners and your employers. I'm sorry. So this can be only possible when you will make yourself independent. Either you are a holiday owner or a tourism professional. And in order to become independent, you have to master of your trade or profession. There is no other way. Many of you who wants to enter into a holiday business thinks that if I will take a franchisee or tie up with some big brand, my business will be settled because I'll be getting all sorts of support from my franchisor or from my so-called business partner. And to some extent, that's true also. But you always forget that all the support and everything, and all the support and everything that you are getting from the franchisor or from your business partner, the establishment cost and the entire risk are borne by you and not by the franchisor or any of your business partners. The risk and uncertainty is always yours. You just check it out, what I'm telling you. And suppose suddenly any unavoidable situation comes like COVID, then most of the franchisors are not going to give any support, especially financial support. Yes, I can say companies like Airbnb stood during COVID to their business partners. But tell me, how many such companies exist in India as well as in the world? So till you are giving benefit, you are a business partner. And the moment any uncertainty comes, you will find alone to combat the entire situation. So you are dependent, my dear friends. Simply think about it. Now, let's talk about the tourism professionals. You guys are spending lakhs of rupees on completing your graduation and post-graduation in travel, tourism and hospitality courses, and also giving your 2-3 years of valuable time. But after taking that degree, when you enter into any organization to start your career, you have to again take training as if you have started from scratch. I'll boldly say, there is no such curriculum exist in India as well as in the world for tourism package too, so that after completing the course, one can fully be independent to work professionally and practically. So, I'm asking those academicians, why you people are killing so much time for your students, and why you don't take the pain to build such a curriculum that brings out such professionals who can dominate in their respective area of work after getting their degree? Why don't you take so much pain? So even the tourism professionals are not independent. After spending three to four lakhs of rupees and giving 2-3 valuable years of their life. So we need to redefine the tourism business system and the tourism education system. Now many are in tourism business even don't know what is the difference between hotel packages and tour packages. How many types of trip cards are there to make a perfect tour plan? How to send a presentable quotation, because the quotation is the first impression and the tool to convert your inquiries into sales. So there are many things you need to learn, you need to know and implement in your business or career in order to become independent. I'll tell you another important mindset of our small and medium holiday owners. They have a mindset that mindset is being injected by the market players, that they cannot be able to compete with the price of big players because they are big, they have bulk purchasing power, and they are well connected. That's true also that they get special rates from the group of hotels and hoteliers. I can say the airlines also give a special rate to them because of many reasons like pre-purchasing power. So this mindset has been injected into you so that you can always be dependent on them and give business to them, and you should not be independent. Unki business mein effect hoga. But it is absolutely not true that you cannot be able to compete with them with your package tour business. I'll tell you that. My dear friends, you can compete with any damn company if you know the system and if you know how. So, Would you like to know how you can be able to become independent in your business and can be able to build a brand in the market? Would you like to become an asset to any company, because just carrying a degree or a diploma will not be able to survive you in the professional world? I'll tell you. So if you are keen to know many such things that will spin your head, then I'm going to decode the future tourism threats and the opportunities post-pandemic. It will not be a short session like 60 minutes or 90 minutes. This will be 120 minutes of free masterclass. And also, I'll be showing you how you can be able to come under one umbrella of your own. You will not be dependent on anyone. You can be able to build a brand and you can become fully independent. It's a worldwide movement that I have started. And it's for you, the small and medium holiday owners and tourism professionals. Invest your time and I will show you that you don't have to be at the mercy of anyone to do your business or in your profession. Click on the link and get yourself registered to be the part of this movement. Cheers, guys. See you in my masterclass.